Ponticelli, Napoli, and the homecoming of the Universiade 1959. And Turin is where the games begin. 60 years on, and the great city of Naples in the Mezzogiorno, the capital of Campania, hosts the 30th edition of this melding of academic and sporting brilliance. What of today? It's apparatus finals day. Today, it's about the specialists.
Floor, Japan, Kakeru Tanigawa.
And so to Kakeru Tanigawa, team gold medalist. And the gymnast who was in fourth position in the all-around competition behind teammate Kazumakaya, Ivan Stretovic and Lee Chikai. Away he goes, third strongest qualifier. Superb precision. That'll do to get us started, won't it? A really nice beginning from Kakeru Tanigawa. Perhaps his final tumbling pass was the least secure of all of them. 14.55 is the score for Kakeru Tanigawa.
You, Russia. Kirill Prokopov.
Now here comes the fun bit. Isn't that great? He's got a high difficulty. 6.2 was his qualification difficulty score. It's a wonderful routine. It's a really nicely constructed piece of gymnastics. And Kirill Prokopiev goes into the gold medal position.
And 95, Japan, Kazumakaya.
Quite sure that the last couple of tumbling passes have been as tidy as they were in qualification, but he's so quick in the Russian vendor swing. One would certainly expect this to be there or thereabouts in terms of a podium place. Kaya is in the silver medal position with a score of 14.6.
14, first place of Kirill Prokopov.
So it is the bronze for Kakeru Tanigawa of Japan, the silver for Kazumakaya of Japan, and the gold for Kirill Prokopiev of the Russian Federation. Kazumakaya, the second strongest qualifier on the pommel horse. Very tidy hand placement. Lower body is precise. He keeps it together in the Russian even better, which he does. And again there, giving a great deal away in this second part of the routine, that's for sure. into the flares, which he does with speed and precision. Just a little bit low there, coming towards the dismount, and his legs got ever so slightly tangled moving into that. But it's a very good display once more from Kazuma Kaya. So it's a 14.5 for Kaya. So Kaya, Tone, Patron, 1-2-3, Nariman Kurbanov of Kazakhstan. Another gymnast who is from Almaty, much like Milad Karimi. He's the third strongest qualifier. He's got a good record in pommel horse competitions. Just lost his elegance a touch, but didn't last long at all. And there's some nice one-handle work. He has a fluidity, a fluency on this piece, Nariman Kurbanov. And he's gone into the lead, Nariman Kurbanov. A score of 14.7. Now, Li Chikai of Chinese Taipei, the top qualifier. Here is the reigning champion from the last summer Universiade. Gymnast who studied at Taiwan Sport University. And here he goes into the big flare work. He's just become a blur in this sequence. So pacey is he, but his execution is very good. Toes pointed. Hips high above the handles. Isn't he just wonderful to watch on this piece? It's a masterclass. Every time you see Li Chikai perform. And he has absolutely romped to this. What a huge score, 15.4. The silver medal to Nariman Kurbanov with his great display of 14.7. He was leading right up until Li Chikai came in as the last performer to take the gold medal. Kazuma Kaya, who got things underway, takes a bronze and yet another medal for the Japanese gymnast. It's time for the final apparatus final of this first session of action here at the Palais Vesuvio. Ibrahim Jolak of Turkey. Pulls up with strength into the planche. And also sustains the Maltese well, goes back into the planche position. He's got a very nice line. Milwaukee Jonasson combination is smooth. Back into the Maltese. This is very tidy. Level presentation on the shoulders. And again, he's just got a little lateral movement of the rings to address. Takes a moment to stabilize the handstand, but he's done that well. He's a very good performer on this piece. Great score from Jolak, 14.8. But here is a very interesting competitor indeed. Artur Avetisyan. Really emphatic opening up of the hands. This is excellent. So stable. the biggest adjustment we've seen so far on that handstand. That shows just how little he's had to adjust. He adjusts nothing in his dismount. What a great display from Artur Avetisyan of Armenia. What he might be taking away is a gold medal. 14.9, Artur Avetisyan. Vincent's Hook.
Austria.
...23-year-old studies at the University of Innsbruck. He was the second reserve for the rings final at the European Championships in Szczecin a couple of months ago. Really nice shoulder presentation in the cross. It was wonderfully straight. As is that. Super execution. Very promising indeed from Vincent's Hook.
Austria.
And he's got the 6-2 this time. Ooh. And as a result, he is in the silver medal
That's
position.
The for the
so we bring you the confirmed standings in the men's still rings competition. Two silver medals, Ibrahim Zsolak and Vincent Hurk of Turkey and Austria, respectively. And the gold to Artur Avetisyan of Armenia. Very tight competition. Just a tenth between that gold and joint silver positions. And the reason it's joint is that they are absolutely tied on 6.2 difficulty and 8.6 execution.
Attention.
So here they come, the eight competitors who've made it into the final of the men's vault competition here at Napoli 2019. 14.4 is the score there for Luis Porto. So a little bit of an advancement from his first vault in qualifying by half a tenth. This is not as difficult a vault if he attempts the same things he did in qualifying. It's very stable indeed. Oh, super. You know what, I think he's a touch pleased with that one. And certainly be harbouring feelings of joy as that score comes in. Oh, it's a very good execution score.
Second vault.
Igor Shalamkov has delivered an absolute belter of a vault. 14.45 the score, 9.25 execution. Here comes the second. This wasn't quite as strong in qualifying. Oh, that was big. That was a big vault. That was more so, I think, than qualification. But people will remember him now because he's gone into a leading position. 14.8 goes up by half a tenth.
Secondo salto.
So he's reasonably on course here, Kim Hansol, to move into the lead if he can have stable execution in this second. Let us find out. Certainly can, and he really gets distance away from the table. The 23-year-old who's a student of education at the Korean National Sport University. 14.65. Consequently, these are the final standings. Luis Porto of Brazil getting a bronze medal. Igor Shalamkov of Belarus securing the silver. Great moment for him after missing out on a few occasions recently. And Kim Hansol of the Republic of Korea is the Universiade champion. The start list for the men's parallel bars final. Ahmet Unde of Turkey, the second strongest in qualification. Really did get some height under. Superb handstand work. Nice dismount too. Young gymnast from Izmir. He goes into the lead, 14.45 for the Turkish gymnast. He's now in the gold medal position. The silver medalist in the all-around competition, Ivan Stredovich of the Russian Federation. An Olympic medalist in Rio 2016. He's got to correct at the start. Very nice from Ivan Stredovich, a gymnast who has developed confidence enormously here. And he might well be taking another gold medal here. That's a really good score indeed for Stredovich. 14.95 was the score for Kakeru Tanigawa with his qualification display. Get full travel down those bars. It's going to be a very tough wait indeed now for Ivan Stredovich. Hard to tell whether Kakeru Tanigawa thinks he's done enough or not. He is going to get a prize, but it's going to be a silver medal, 14.55 for Kakeru Tanigawa. And Ivan Stretovic has won the competition. Now, hang on a moment. We just heard a noise there saying that the parallel bars inquiry has been accepted. So, Kakeru Tanigawa, 14.85. Now there is confirmation of the change to the parallel bar standings. Ivan Stredovic drops down to silver medal, Kakeru Tanigawa goes up to gold. Ahmet Unde, bronze medal position, remaining the same for him. And on we go with the final, the men's horizontal bar competition. The Olympic silver medalist, Ivan Stredovic. Was a bronze medalist at the Russian Championships on the horizontal bar earlier this year. Very much the sort of environment we know him to be a real performer in. A lovely one-arm giant, a theatrical one-arm giant. Does get nice amplitude on the Katchev into the Pike Katchev with the crosshand grip. Straddle Katchev with a crosshand, so a couple of crosshand grip catches. A lot of height on his dismount, a very steady landing. He is now in contention too.
Ivan Stretovic
Stredovic goes into the gold medal position, 14.6 for him. Tang Chia-Hung of Chinese Taipei, the 22-year-old. Just taken a silver medal at the Asian Championships in Mongolia on the horizontal bar. And he won the Asian Games gold last year on this piece. He is very, very good. A really nice looking Yamawaki. Really does float over the bar. White Kavchev to mix grip. Straddle Kavchev to mix grip. It is a swingful and fluid routine, and suddenly we are seeing gymnasts really deliver in this horizontal bar final. Tang Chia-Hung has gone into the gold medal position, and look at what it means. Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan. So, Tang Chia-Hung leads. Ivan Stredovic second. Ahmed Under third. And this the turn of the sixth strongest qualifier. He has just so much power and controls the Kovacs. And then that Coleman move. Kovacs with the turn. Well, Milad Karimi, you do make things interesting. It's a really good score for Milad Karimi. It's not quite enough to take the gold medal. 14.675, but he doesn't care because he's got a medal. Tang Chia-Hung doing what top qualifiers should do and winning the gold. Milad Karimi, a silver medal for him, the gymnast from Kazakhstan. He was very close, as indeed was Ivan Stredovic of the Russian Federation, who takes the bronze medal.